In this video, I'm going to show you that not only can you use Desmos to answer questions involving equivalent expressions, but you can easily do them in under 90 seconds. In this first question, we have an equation that relates NT and W. The question is asking for an expression that's equivalent to N. On this test, that's the same thing as saying solve for N or give me N in terms of T and W. We're going to start by typing a given equation into Desmos and substituting in values for T and W. We're not going to use a 0, a 1, or two numbers of the same because we can end up with undefined or the same value for more than one answer choice. We're going to use 2 and 3. And we're going to assign them to T and W in alphabetical order so it's easy to remember which one goes with which. So T equals 2, W equals 3. And finally, we're going to reread the question to make sure we're not breaking any rules by using 2 and 3. So I'm reading the question and I see that N and T are both positive, and that W is greater than T, and so we're good to go with T equals 2 and W equals 3. Now let's type it into Desmos. Typing it in, and there's my value of N. Now to get that value of N, you're going to make sure you use a tilde instead of an equal sign. The next step is to evaluate the answer choice expressions using 2 and 3 to see if you get the same answer. Now, I know this may look like a lot of typing, but the expected number of trials to get the right answer is 2.25, and you'll never need to type more than 3 because if the first 3 don't work, the fourth one is the right answer. And finally, take a look at the last 2 answer choices. They are almost identical, and this happens a lot on this test. So you type in the first one, and if the answer doesn't work, duplicate, edit, and see what your next answer is. So it's really not that hard to get the right answer in under 90 seconds. All right, we're going to start inputting them. So I'm typing in the first one. I don't get the same answer. I'm typing in the second one. I don't get the same answer. I'm typing in the third one, and we don't get the same answer. Since the first 3 didn't work, the fourth one is the right answer. But I'm going to go ahead and do the fourth one anyways, just so you can see how easy it is to duplicate and edit. All right, we start by hitting the duplicate button. We duplicate the third one. We come down. We put parens around this. And then I'm going to take it to the minus 1 power, which basically flips a fraction. And there's our answer, 36. Why does this work? Well, the mathematician side of me says that it is possible in theory to get the same result for 2 answer choices. I know this because I graphed a whole bunch of these in 3 dimensions and I see that some of them do overlap. But the engineer side of me says, look, I respect that theory, but we have a real life problem. We have constraints we put on the numbers we choose to use, and the SAT writers have constraints on the algebraic expressions they create. When you combine those constraints, it lowers the probability of getting the same result for 2 answer choices down to next to nothing. And then let's look at the downside. Well, you're doing it this way because you couldn't do them algebraically, and it takes less than 90 seconds to do one of these. So it's not like you're putting time into this that you could be spending on other problems to get more points. It's really important you stick around for the next couple of examples because they have differences that could throw you off. And since there's usually 2 or 3 of these on each test, you don't want to just kind of know how to do these. You want to own these. This next one wants you to find W in terms of X and Y. That's the same thing as finding an expression that's equivalent to W. Let's see if we can use 2 and 3 again. The question says distinct, which means different, positive real values. All right, so we're good to go with X equals 2 and Y equals 3. Typing a given equation into Desmos using 2 for X and 3 for Y, and there's our answer. Before we do more typing, let's take a second to look at the answer choices. The first and the second are almost identical, and the third and the fourth are also almost identical. So the duplicate button will save us a lot of time on these. Typing in the first one, and we don't get the same answer. Duplicate the first one, squeezing in the 28 and the 14, and we don't get the same answer. Typing in the third one, and this one works. I'm going to go ahead and do the fourth one anyways, just so you can see that that one doesn't work. Duplicate the third one, squeezing the 28 and the 14, and this one doesn't work. Notice we got the right answer in well under 90 seconds. This last question just asked for which expression is equivalent, and there's no restrictions on the variables, so we're going to use 2 and 3 again. And just so you know, I've worked through every question involving equivalent expressions in the SAT digital PDFs, and I didn't find a single case where 2 and 3 didn't work. I will admit this looks like a lot of typing, but look at the first and the fourth answer choices. They have the same denominator, and the third and the fourth have the same numerator. So with duplicate, we'll still get this done in under 90 seconds. Typing a given equation into Desmos using 2 for X and 3 for Y, and there's our answer. I'm just going to start with the first answer choice. I am definitely not using the second because it doesn't look anything like the others. So typing in the first, here we go, typing in, and I don't get the same answer. So now what I'm going to do is it has the same denominator the first one does as the fourth one. So I'm just going to duplicate it. And then I'm going to edit the numerator. And there we go. And we don't get the same answer. So the third one now has the same numerator as this fourth one. So I'm going to duplicate the fourth one. And I'm going to edit the denominator. And here we go. And we get the right answer. So at this point, I'm not going to bother typing in the second one. We already got the right answer. And notice we did it in under 90 seconds. I'm Raymond P. Hunter. As an undergrad, I studied math, engineering, and physics at grad school, math, engineering, and actuarial science. Over the last 35 years, I've helped thousands of students, schools, and school districts improve their math performance. If you have any questions for me regarding SAT, math, or anything else, just leave me in the comments section.